Welcome back. And the tea prices as well have been rallying for the last couple of years. And we have seen not just the prices in India, but the global markets as well gain on the higher side. There, of course, have been crop concerns, strong global consumption. The Indian market consumption as well has been gaining year-on-year basis, and that has taken the prices on the higher side. Of course, with the kind of crop that we are seeing in the global markets, perhaps Indian exports can also increase. But how competitive are we and where are the prices headed? What is the industry looking at? For all of that, we are now joined by Mr. Kamal Baheti, who is CFO, McLeod Russell. Also joining us is Mr. DP Maheshwari, MD and CEO, Jayashree Tea and Industries Limited. Mr. Baheti, hi, let me start with you first of all. And the latest news that we heard in the last 1 week was that the Commerce Ministry is looking to merge various commodity boards. And one of them, of course, is tea as well. How have you taken the news as an industry, and is it a plus or a negative?
No, in fact, we take it as is various basis. As far as Tea Board of India is concerned, they were dedicated particular to tea, and they were concerned which has been considered by Tea Board as well as by the Commerce Ministry whenever this has been raised by the industry. So even if there is a composite board and there is a department which look after tea separately, and then the concerns are being taken in board and then resolved, we have got absolutely no issue on this. We have to really look at how this works. But it has been tea board separately for many, many years. So we have to look forward into the new one.
Well, absolutely. Mr. Maheshwari, getting you in the conversation as well. For the longest time, we've always spoken on how India is a tea drinking nation. But the cost of producing tea in the Indian markets has always been on the higher side. So how would you address that? I mean, how competitive are we when it comes to the global markets?
Well, you see, cost being high, as you know, labor costs are more than 60% of our cost of production. And with aspirations going up, you can't grudge the increase to the labor. So you have to take it, accept it that this segment cost will continue to go up. Now, what is to be done is that, we improve our quality and get better prices. This year, unfortunately, for high quality teas, the prices to start with were not good. In fact, some, they were down by almost 20-30 rupees. Only in the last phase of the year, situation has started improving. And now if you see, production is up by around 35 million kilogram. 30 million kilograms our production is up this year. And 30 to 35 million is the additional demand each year needed. So if you see stock production and stock, there is not a problem. And new season tea, when they start coming to market in March, I expect prices to again jump. One added factor is that last year March was a all-time bumper March, which we are not going to repeat this year because weather conditions are not that conducive as they were last year. So again, we will be in a situation where there will be a shortage of tea, and good tea will again continue to get good prices.
All right.
So I personally feel that prices will be good.
Okay. I will come back to you, Mr. Maheshwari, on how much price rise can we see here. But Mr. Baheti, the same question to you. Would you agree with the kind of figures Mr. Maheshwari has come out with? We can see more 35 million kgs of output this time around.
No, as far as 2016 is concerned, the numbers are out. The total as an industry, we are up by around 25-30 million kilograms, as Mr. Maheshwari had said. But demand has also grown by 25-30 million. But if I have to really look at last 2-3 years overall production, it has been very much in the range of 1.2 billion. So there has been no increase. The overall prices in 2016 has been a little subdued, mainly because we had a bumper crop in Kenya, which is 70 odd million kilograms in the first quarter of 2016, and that had an impact on exports and overall prices. But as we come into the new season, there is a big drop in the crop in Kenya, which is being expected because of the drought. The prices in Kenya and international market is up by 30-40% in last 2 months. We in India is looking at March being lower than last year. Even if you do the normal crop, the consumption growth itself, it need 30-35 million more crop, which is very unlikely to come. So I agree with Mr. Maheshwari that as far as the opening level in India is concerned for the new season tea, the prices may be very strong. And we had a 2-3 years of down cycle on prices. I think we are at the age of now turning around and maybe a couple of years may be very good on prices.
All right,
and
that
it may be the catalyst, maybe the shortage in Kenya, which is already there.
Absolutely. So that really sounds like a good start to your industry then. But what kind of a jump up are we looking in prices? I mean, both of you gentlemen are quite clear on the kind of shortage that we might be seeing. But what kind of a jump up are we expecting from here? And would you say that this season might see 10 to 15% of a jump up in prices? Or are we looking at something more? Mr. Bahety, you go first.
No, if I have to really again go by the cycle itself, we had a poor cycle from 2001 to 2004. As we started going up, in 5 years we doubled the prices from 2006 to 2012, 5-6 years. We had been very, very subdued on prices for last 3 years. I see no reason why prices can't really go substantially over the next 3-4 years.
Hmm.
Whether it goes up by 15, 20 rupees or 10% next year is something which I really can't say. But I think the change is there. The overall demand situation will now be more than what the supply side will be, as the demand has gone to a different kind of a level. So prices may be very strong. We expect opening level to be around 10 to 15% higher than the last year.
All right. Mr. Maheshwari, what's your sense? I mean, domestic demand itself is on the higher side, and India perhaps is in a sweet spot when it comes to the global demand and prices also. What kind of exports are we looking at, and how competitive are we onto that?
See, we are definitely fully competitive. This year also our prices are on exports are quite good. Though exports in totally are down, that is mainly because of higher crop in Kenya. And now that Kenyan crop is reported to be very low, and it could be as low at 40 to 45 million kilogram in first 3 months, as happened 2 years back, so exports will definitely pick up.
Hmm.
As far as prices in India is concerned, I fully agree with Kamal that prices definitely will go up. We are due for this jump. And, you know, it's a cycle. It has happened earlier on also. It will happen now also. Only change is that quality teas will be better rewarded and lower price teas probably will be rejected. That is what the scenario I see. And I definitely feel that prices will go up. Next 3-4 years, we will have good pricing.
All right. Mr. Bahety, just coming to you with the new, new flavors, the green tea, the carbonated tea, packaged tea, all of that as well now has a very significant growing market. What is your sense on how much will that now take as your market share? And also, what is your sense on what are going to be the major importing countries when it comes to tea?
No, let me first put it that whether it is green tea or any other tea, the raw material is the same. If you produce more green tea, you will be producing less black tea. It is not a different tea with leaf which makes the different kind of tea. It is only the manufacturing process. Green tea as a percentage may increase higher, but the base is very low. If you really look at the tea as a beverage, it is very much rural, and there is no green tea in the rural markets if you really go. As far as looking at the importing countries are concerned, you see, India is the only black tea consumer as well as the producer of the tea, the largest. Rest of the producing countries are not the consuming countries, and the rest of the consuming countries are not the producing countries. So the consumption is right from Russia, Middle East, Pakistan, UK, Egypt, etc. And these are consumption stories. Now the growth is going to be there. Our expectation is that around 2% consumption growth every year, which means 60-65 million kilograms of additional requirement of tea globally, out of which 30-35 million itself will come from India, which is growing at around 3-4% per annum. So, and being a gestation period of 5 years for any new land to come under tea plantation, I think the supply side will get squeezed and there will be more demand. And
okay,
the prices will keep on looking up. It will be a cycle. I don't know how long this cycle lasts. But I think we are at the verge of getting into a better cycle now.
Okay. Mr. Maheshwari, just one final word with you before we let you guys go. What is your sense on the policies that the tea as an industry is looking at right now? The import duty is higher, the countervailing duty as well. What is your sense? Do you want anything to be changing there as an industry? Are you asking something from the ministry?
I don't think we have got anything to be asked from the ministry. Because, you know, it's a fairly market forces, demand supply is operating as far as pricing is concerned.
Okay.
Regulatory things, we are already working with some amendment changes in Plantation Labor Act. Social, social obligations, statutory obligations under Plantation Labor Act is a burden for industry which is unique to plantation industry, for which already talks are going on. I hope something on that thing comes up. Otherwise, I have got nothing to ask to the government.
Well, that's a very, very positive ending to that conversation there, Mr. Baheti and Mr. Maheshwari. Thank you so much. Well, that is all that you wanted to know about the tea industry from the tea champions there itself. The view, of course, is quite bullish going forward from here. The growth is just about started. And the next 3 to 4 years are expected very positive for the industry, is the view coming in from our experts. But with that, it's a wrap up on this edition of Commodity Champions. Thank you for watching.